morning and boker tov, everybody. I hope you are all doing great. In today's halacha, we are continuing with halachot Tisha B'Av, the laws of Tisha B'Av, and we move on to the next topic, which is rechitza v'sicha. Rechitza means washing, shower, bath, and sicha means moisturizing or applying something on the skin for pleasure purposes. So let's focus on washing. You should know that the halacha forbids anybody to wash their skin, even with a cold shower, it makes no difference. Even if it's one tiny finger, we consider all the isur of rechitza and part of the avelut, the mourning that we observe on Tisha B'Av. Therefore, if a lady, for example, has to go to the mikveh on Motzae Tisha B'Av, so after Tisha B'Av, she will have to prepare herself only after the end of the fast, because beforehand that will be asur. Now, we do have some exceptions, and I would already start with something that probably this year is more of actuality, when we wash our hands not for pleasure purposes, but for hygiene purposes. So that's definitely a good question, and it seems that if it's only because of the microbes, the germs, etc., then it should not be a problem. I'm going to give you some other examples that we find in the halakha that are mutah. For example, if a person has a dirty spot on the skin, the halakha allows to wash only that area. Also, if when the person is going to the bathroom in the, or he wakes up in the morning and he has to do netilat yadayim, that is to remove the ruach ra'a, the bad spirit, then it's okay according to the halakha to do so up to the knuckles. If a person is sick, lo alenu, and he has to eat on Tisha B'Av, and he plans to have hamotzi, so he has to wash his hands in order to eat bread. That will be even mutar up to the wrist because it's a shem mitzvah. It's not really shem ta'anug, it's for the mitzvah of the netilat yadayim. Same thing for the kohanim who are going to perform berkat kohanim in the tefilot. So they are allowed to wash their hands even up to the wrist because it's a torech mitzvah. The leviyim, on the other hand, meaning the ones that are going to wash the kohanim's hand, it's not the same level, so it's only up to the knuckles. When ladies are washing meat to be cooked for the next seudah, for the breaking the fast, for example, for those who are eating meat, because it's really a machloket, according to Sefaradim, that will be only allowed the next day after Hatzot. But any food that is being washed, it's okay to do so on Tisha B'Av, because it's not l'shem ta'anug, and even if it's using hot water. Now, this is all about rechitza, so washing on Tisha B'Av. Let's talk about moisturizing. So, like I said before, it's only when it's about pleasure. So, if it is a cream that you have to apply for health purposes, okay, for a treatment that you have to follow, then it would be mutar to do so on Tisha B'Av. Another question that is interesting is deodorant. When you apply a deodorant on the skin that is to prevent or remove a bad odor, that's mutar. That's not considered moisturizing. That's also considered as if you would be treating the situation and therefore permissible on the day of Tisha B'Av. I wish you all an amazing, cool and safe day.